In this video, we're going to learn about the remove overlaps function. And to get started, I'm just going to click on an empty workspace and use my shape tool to, first of all, create a rectangle. Then I'm going to select another shape and draw something that's overlapping. So here you can see that we have two shapes that have an area where they overlap. And ideally, we would like to not have the stitching of the square be behind the circle. And to check, you know, the way the design is going to stitch out, I can use my slow redraw tool. And if I just grab on the needle here and click and drag to study how the design's going to sew, I can see that, in fact, the square does have the stitching removed under the circle. And it does both the square and then the circle and then outlines both. Now keep in mind that I have currently the auto sequence control turned on, and if I was to turn that off, how would that change the way the design is going to stitch out? So if we do a slow redraw now, we can see that it does still removes the stitches underneath the square, but it does do the outline of the square at the same time. Then it does the circle, and then the outline of the circle. So that was because we changed the automatic sewing sequence to be manual, which separated the circle from the square. I can turn that back on, but how do you control the removing of the stitches? Well, that is done by the object that is on top, in other words, the circle. If I select the circle and look at its fill properties, at the very bottom it says remove overlaps and it's set to auto. If I change the auto to never, then it will never remove the stitches of any objects that are underneath of this circle. And so now if I turn on slow redraw, you can see that it's going to sew the entire rectangle, then outline the entire rectangle before finally sewing the entire circle. And that is because we turned off the remove overlaps function on this circle. And so the options are never, auto, and always. Now, always would make sure that it always trims. Never, make sure that it never trims. And auto will make sure that it trims when the software decides it's appropriate. And that is going to be based upon size. Because I guess if I made this circle small enough, we might say that it's not necessarily required or needed for those stitches to be removed. Now, I'm not sure exactly how small I would need to make it before the software would make that determination, because it's still doing it there. But I know, for example, with lettering, where you have small satin columns, that it won't. And so to demonstrate that, perhaps what I could do is get rid of the circle and add a piece of text on top. So maybe we'll just put in here, I set my cap locks on. Trev, select that and place that text on top of the fill. Sorry, that's the base. Place that text on top. Well, undo. I kind of flipped it. Where's the move? There's the move. Okay, so here we have text on top of fill. Will it, the remove overlaps on the text is turned to auto. So the question is, will it remove the stitching when we go to slow redraw? And the answer is no, it does not appear that it's trimmed any of the background away. And so that is the, I guess, the power of the automatic versus the never and the always, is that the software is able to make the determination when it would be best to remove the overlaps.